Good morning. Welcome to today's class. We have 15 minutes ahead of us. We're going to get straight to it. So take a seat, cross your legs. I hope you're feeling well in your body and your mind. And if not, let's just do some yoga together and perhaps you'll feel better afterwards. All right, so get a blanket, bolster, blocks, whatever you need to sit comfortably. And then just close your eyes. See if you can connect to your both sitting bones. Lift through the chest. Roll your shoulders back. Breathe in and out through your nose. Close your eyes. Focus on your third eye, the space in between your eyebrows. And then just relax your palms onto your knees. Relax your elbows. Breathe in through your nose. And out through your nose. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Last round, inhale. And exhale. Open your eyes, tilt your head over towards the right. Let your both shoulders still be parallel. And then move over to the left. Move over to the right. And to the left. And then from here, look over your right shoulder. Look over your left one. Right shoulder. And then left one. Keep your palms onto your knees and then just start doing these circles with the upper body. So when you go forward, you're breathing in, you're kind of pushing the chest forward. When you're going back, you're exhaling and rounding the back. And then as far out to your sides, to the right and to the left. And then opposite the rotation from here. Breathing in and out through your nose. Last two rounds. And then exhale. Come back to center. Come forward on your mat. Place your palms down, knees down. Come to all fours. So palms are under your shoulders, knees are under your hips. Toes can be tucked or point your toes back, doesn't matter. From here, inhale, arch your spine forward. Exhale, round through the back, look to your navel. Inhale, forward. Exhale, round. Inhale, forward. Exhale, round. Two more times. Inhale, moving forward, cat and cow. Last round, move forward. Exhale, round. All right, so from here, tuck your toes, lift your knees just a few centimeters off the ground, and see here if you can engage your belly. And keep this engagement, and then lift through your knees higher, lift through your hips back, and come to a downward facing dog. Breathing in. Breathing out. Pedal out through your feet and knees. Just walk on your spot here. Two more breaths. And exhale. All right, so we're going to move from a downward facing dog to an activated child's pose. So from here, we keep our downward facing dog, and then we bend through the knees, we sit back to our heels, but we keep our knees lifted all the time from the ground. So an activated child's pose looks like this. And then downward facing dog. Child's pose, downward facing dog. Child's pose, downward facing dog. Three more times. This really fires up the whole body, keeps our arms strong, keeps our legs strong. And last round, And then come back to your downward facing dog. Walk your palms all the way back to your feet. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Hold around the elbows. Move the upper body forward. Just let your upper body relax forward. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. And as you exhale, walk your palms back to a downward facing dog. And we're going to do some spinal rolls. All right, so come high up onto your toes. Move forward through a plank pose. Curve the upper back, so you're rounding the upper back as much as possible. And once you kind of get forward here, you start to bend your knees and move back almost through this activated child's pose. So moving forward, moving back. Forward, moving back. Five more. One, two, three, four, and last round, come forward, and then stay in your downward facing dog, take a deep breath in and lift your right leg up, exhale, step forward in between your palms, lower the back knee down. Come to a low lunge, lift your upper body, lift your chest, breathe in, arms lift. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale, release your palms, tuck your back toes under, lift that back knee and lift your right arm. Come into a twist here. Inhale. And exhale. So from here, we're going to move to a Parshva Konasana. So we're going to release the back heel down. Let our right palm come to the inside of our right foot. And then instead of lifting that right arm, we're going to lift the left arm. So the front knee is still bent, back leg is straight, heel is down. Heels are in a straight line. Lifting through your left arm, breathing in. And as you breathe out, release, step back with your right foot, downward facing dog. Take a breath here. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, lift your left leg up. Step forward, exhale. Release your back knee down. Untuck your toes. Inhale, lift your arms. Low lunge, keep lowering through your hips, bending through the front knee. Inhale, exhale, inhale, and as you exhale, come down with your palms, tuck the back toes under, lift the knee, and then lift your left arm. Breathe in and out through your nose, long, deep breaths. And then as you exhale, release the back heel down, release the left palm down to the inside of your left foot, and then reach the right arm up. Parshva Konasana. Breathing in. Breathing out. Gaze up to your right palm if possible. Last breath, inhale. And exhale, look down, release that arm, step back, downward facing dog. Inhale and exhale. All right, so we're gonna move from a downward facing dog to an upward facing dog. So you can always modify here and just go from a downward facing dog to plank pose and then shift. So go forward and go back. If you feel like your spine is warm, then come forward and then just keep your arms straight here. Lower the hips, roll the shoulders back and come to a upward facing dog. So we have, either you can keep your toes tucked here and move from a downward facing dog to an upward facing dog, or you can untuck your toes. This is a little bit more hardcore. And then when you move forward, you come directly to an upward facing dog. So choose your option here. Let's start together in a downward facing dog, so either to plank or upward.
All right, so I'm gonna untuck my toes here. You choose an option that suits you. Come forward
and then lower down. Lift up.
Five more rounds.
Inhale and exhale. That's one. And two,
three more. Two last ones. And then last one here. And then come to a downward facing dog. Breathing in.
And as you breathe out, start to walk your feet forward. Come all the way forward. Stay in an uttanasana. Big toes are touching. Heels can be separated. Bend your knees as much as you need to.
And then inhale, roll all the way up.
Arms up over your head.
Exhale, roll all the way down. Inhale, come halfway up.
Exhale, step back to a plank pose. From here, go through a chaturanga, upward facing dog, and exhale, downward facing dog.
All right, so step halfway forward with your right foot.
Come up high on your fingertips, on your both feet, both palms here, and then lift the back leg, point the toes out to the side. All right, so from here, we're gonna come to our half moon, our Ardha Chandrasana. So the right palm is right under our right shoulder. We're keeping our right leg slightly bent, or if you can keep it straight, then do that. And we're pushing the left heel all the way back, pointing the toes out. And then perhaps if you find the balance, you may lift the left arm, perhaps look up towards the left fingertips. And then let's keep that left leg in line with our hips. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. And breathe out, release. Step all the way back to a downward facing dog. And then step your left foot halfway forward. Come high up onto your fingertips. Lift the right leg, toes out. Push the heel back, straight left leg or slightly bend the knee. And then if you're ready, if you find the balance, you find somewhere to place your gaze, then lift the right arm, breathing in, breathing out, lowering the right leg in line with your hips, flex through the toes. Two more breaths here. And exhale, release down, step back, downward facing dog. And directly just bend your right knee in towards the chest, move forward, and then place it down in between your palms. Come to a pigeon pose. All right, so upper body is lifted. Breathe in. Breathe out. Try not to dump all the weight over to the right. Keep it in the middle. One more breath here, and then when you're ready, just let that left leg come forward, cross it over the right one, hold around the left leg with your right arm, and then twist back to the left. And then come forward, go back, downward facing dog. Same thing, opposite side. So left knee in towards the chest, move forward, lower down, pigeon pose, breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. One last breath here, upper body is straight. And then see if you can just swing that right leg forward, cross it over the left knee, And then twist over to the right, looking over the right shoulder. Breathe in. And breathe out. Last breath. And then come forward. Go all the way back from your downward facing dog. Let's just meet in this active child's pose. And then when you're ready, release the knees all the way down. Sit back to your heels. And then eventually find your seated pose. Legs are crossed. Back is straight. Chested. Pulsing. Eyes are closed. Breathe in and out through the nose. Come back to your soft breath. And then when you're ready, inhale, lift your arms up over your head, connect your palms. Exhale, lower in front of your chest. And then let's inhale for an om together. Breathe in. Namaste. Great job, guys. Thank you for joining today's class. I'll see you again tomorrow. And I hope your bodies are feeling well. Have a lovely day and see you. Take care. Bye.